Good day, students. Today we will going to continue our lesson about decimal. Yesterday we discussed how to add decimal, and for today's lesson we will going to learn how to subtract decimals. Okay, now let's start. Before we begin, let me ask you this question. Do you know how to subtract decimals? Okay. Subtracting decimals is just the same in adding decimals, and the only difference is we subtract. Okay, now let us try these examples. So let's start with number one. We have 564,000 subtracted by 354,000. Okay, now when we subtract decimals, always begin in the thousands place, or the numbers on the right. Okay, now let's start. 4 minus 4, we have 0. 6 minus 5, we have 1. 5 minus 3, we have 2. And don't forget to align our decimal point. And 0 minus 0, the answer is 0. So for our final answer, we have 210. Or 210,000. Okay, so always remember grade 5 that when we subtract decimals, the first thing that we need to do is to put our numbers in column form or in vertical form, aligning our decimals. In this case, I already aligned our decimals, or I already put the decimals into column form, and I already aligned our decimal point. Okay, so once you already aligned our decimal point and put it into vertical form, then we could now start subtracting. Let's go to number 2. We have 489,000 subtracted by 270,000. Let's start with the number on the very right part, or on the right part. We have 9 minus 0, we have 9. 8 minus 7, we have 1. 4 minus 2, we have 2. And align our decimal point. And 0 minus 0, the answer is 0. And for our final answer, we have 219,000. Okay, so it's very easy, right? It's just like we are adding whole numbers. But the only difference is we have the decimal point. Now let's start with, or let's continue with the number 3. We have 524,000 subtracted by 154,000. So we have 4 minus 4, we have 0. We have 2 minus 5. Very good. Can you subtract 2 minus 5? Of course not, because 2 is lesser than 5. So we cannot subtract 2 by 5. But instead, we were going to borrow to the number on its left. And we're going to borrow to 5. So, 5 will become 4. And 2 will become 12. So, we can now subtract 12 by 5. 12 minus 5, we have 7. 4 minus 1, we have 3. Align our decimal point. And 0 minus 0, the answer is 0. For our final answer, we have 370,000. Now let us try some word problem. We have here, Joyce loves to take a walk from home to school every morning. The distance of school from their home is 2,6793,000 kilometers. Before going to school, her mother asked her to deliver the bread to her aunt on the next block, which is 1,3201 kilometers away from their home. How many kilometers she needs to walk from her aunt's house going to their school? Now for this instance, we will going to subtract the distance from their home to school. So we have 2,6793,000, subtract it by 1,3201,000. Now let's subtract. Let's start with the number on the right. We have 3 minus 1, we have 2. 9 minus 0, 9. 7 minus 2, very good, that is 5. 6 minus 3, The answer is 3. And don't forget to align the decimal point. It's very important because without the decimal point, then our answer will be wrong. So don't forget to align the decimal point. And 2 minus 1, the answer is 1. So the distance, the choice travel is 1 and 3,592 kilometers. Okay, so always remember that in subtracting decimals, the first thing that we need to do is to align the decimal point in a straight column. Use 0 as a placeholder if needed. Subtract like adding whole numbers, and lastly, align the decimal point in our difference. Okay, so what have you learned for today's lesson? Very good. Thank you so much, grade 5, for listening. I hope to see you again tomorrow for our next math lesson. Bye-bye.